It's yours. You gotta fight.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Strike.
What's that? Is that a tumor?
I've never seen anything like this before.
There's something over there.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I got one. Whoa!
By the butchery work now.
The smaller one has been dragged ashore, and look what's left.
Hi guys, this is Georg. I'm a professor in environmental radioactivity, and this is one of my favorite spots on Earth.
With all the sadness that is linked to the nuclear disaster and that came from it, the beauty of this location is just undeniable. It's a really beautiful place. The cooling pond of the Chernobyl nuclear power plant was once a huge lake, more than 11 kilometers long and 2 or 3 kilometers wide. Now that the water level has dropped so significantly, there are many islands and we wanted to go fishing on one of them. Unfortunately, not all of us had wading boots, so I had to carry my students and my colleagues onto the island. You need rather large bait fish in order to catch one of those bigger catfish that we're after. The good thing is that these fish have never seen a hook in more than 30 years, which makes this location not only one of the most radioactive lakes on Earth, but also one of the most natural waters in Europe.
Strike.
Some nice catfish yesterday, and we're trying to get some bigger ones today. And for the bigger catfish, we need bigger bait. And with one big single hook, we're trying to catch bigger ones.
It's yours. You gotta fight.
There's something over there. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Who are you? Show yourself. I don't want to lose it.
So I'm pumping him back.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Nice fight.
By the butchery work now.
We're looking for strontium 90 concentration in the jawbone as an easily accessible monitor for environmental monitoring. And it's a bit ugly to get it out.
We not only sampled the flesh, but also bone tissue, in particular the jawbone, because bone is famous for accumulating strontium 90, and we wanted to learn more about the strontium 90 contamination levels in this habitat. Last day we were after one rather rare species here.
I got one.
Pike. Pike are very rare in the cooling pond, but we wanted to give it a try to catch one in the Pripyat River Bay.
Whoa! Not a monster.
Not a
baby.
What's this fish?
It's a fish.
Okay. Let's take a look.
Is this pike?
Yeah, I know. I know you don't like it. Ouch. Don't be so stupid.
Yeah. You want to throw him back?
Yes. Bye-bye. Pike.
Yeah.
Hey again. We've tried to lure some animals into the area and have them eat our fish in front of the camera and try to see which animals would come and feast on them.
So this is the spot where we put the catfish yesterday. The bigger one is still there, but the smaller one has been dragged ashore, and look what's left.
On the first day they did this, and on the second day, unfortunately, they didn't. As you can see, all the fish are still there. Well, we will try again. We hope we can catch those animals in action when they're feasting on our fish. Wash him off. But can we take the meat now, just like a strip like this?
How long?
Well, not so long.
You?
It was too much what we took last time.
Is this some dirt? Mm-hmm.
You can feed your family with. Is that the stomach? No. Ah, now all the fish are gone. What's that? Is that a tumor? That's no normal tissue.
We've just had the liver. And now look at this.
Oh my gosh.
I've never seen anything like this before. This is really interesting. This is not any typical fish organ. This is something completely different. It may well be a tumor. Cancer is actually quite rare for animals, even in Chernobyl, because animals simply don't live long enough to develop cancer. But the catfish perhaps is making a nice exception, because he gets very old and they are the end of the food chain. And so it may well be that this is a huge tumor. We will have to check this in the laboratory. More than the size of a grapefruit. Very, very interesting.
The only reason the grapefruit was even invented, the only reason was because God wanted us to have something to compare the size of a tumor to. That's the only reason.
Back in the lab, we've started with the investigation of the fish samples that we have taken, and our friends Moni and Wolfram from Austria came up with a very interesting result. In fact, what we thought would be a tumor is not a cancer. It's just a huge inflammation of the liver. We don't know yet if this inflammation has anything to do with the radioactivity or if it has other reasons, but we are on it. So now it's about the science, and let's see what we find out. We'll let you know. See you, bye-bye, and thanks for watching.